who have been on the Titan, this submarine to go down and see the Titanic, have been talking about how they knew of the risks, or perhaps suspected there were great risks, and had to sign waivers going down. It is 48 hours since it lost contact. And we found out today from the US Coast Guard that there are around 40 hours of breathable air left inside there, which means that by sort of Thursday morning, our time, the air is going to run out. So it is a race against time, and it is a search and rescue mission. Both parts of that are incredibly difficult, searching an area as large as Wales and trying to rescue people that far deep down. So there is a kind of, you know, incredible symmetry about this. It's like a disaster movie of a famous historical disaster. Is there going to be another massive loss of life here? It's rare for things to go wrong on a submersible. So lots of questions are being asked in the papers. But for now, we just have no idea what's going on aboard the submarine.
Yeah, Claire, the Daily Mail also leading with this story tomorrow morning. I was saying to someone today, it really reminds me of the coverage of the young football team in Thailand who were trapped in that cave, and the whole world was rooting for them. But this time, it does seem to be far more challenging because there's just absolutely no idea where they are. And of course, there's a huge expanse that they have to search.
I mean, this is truly the stuff of nightmares, this. Five people trapped in this tiny object. It's only 22 foot long, I think. And they are thousands, probably thousands of meters under the sea's surface. It's absolutely impossible to search the sea. They talk about the surface of the moon being better explored than some of the depths of the ocean. It absolutely is just an impossible task. And the Coast Guard and all of the other agencies involved are truly in a race against time. There are 40 hours of air, they estimate, left in this submarine. It's unimaginable what the people in there are going through. It's just, and for their families as well. It's the fact that, you know, diving is a dangerous endeavour. They've gone down, I think it's 13,000 feet under the sea. The Titanic wreck is located. They were in really difficult weather conditions before they did the dive. And, you know, we just don't know where they are. The US Coast Guard is saying they've had no luck so far. They've searched thousands and thousands of feet of the ocean with planes, with boats, and also I think they've got underwater drones looking for these people. But it is a really, really difficult task, and it is a real race against time. And it must be just unimaginable what their families are going through at the moment. It truly is, you know, a real, real reckoning.
Absolutely. I was speaking to one of the experts we've been interviewing earlier, and I said, you know, it's a needle in a haystack situation. And he said it would be easier to find a needle in a haystack. It really doesn't bear thinking about. But let's hold our breath. There's still time and there's still hope. Let's move on to one of the other main stories leading some of the papers tomorrow, Jenny. The front page of the Financial Times very much focusing on this concern over people's mortgages. One Tory MP calling it a mortgage bomb about to go off.
Yeah, a mortgage time bomb about to go off. That was Jake Berry of one of the Northern research group, Red Wall Seats. Martin Lewis, the big money-saving expert, has also used this phrase, mortgage time bomb about to go off. It is really worrying for people, and there are millions of people, I'm one of them, who are facing the end of their mortgage deals and seeing a huge jump in interest rates. Tomorrow, we are going to see the latest set of inflation figures, and inflation is expected to be down, but not very much, not by very much. We have still the most stubborn inflation and the highest level of inflation of all the G7 countries. And Jeremy Hunt says he cannot provide assistance to people who have mortgages because that would make inflation worse. But he's under pressure from his fellow MPs to do so. I mean, this kind of thing is a real, vote winner, or rather it affects people at the ballot box. And not just people who have mortgages, Renters are facing an enormous squeeze. Rents are going up. Apparently, renters are paying a greater proportion of their wage on rent than they have done for many years, simply because mortgage rates are so high. And interest rates are, of course, expected to go up yet again this year to the highest levels since 2008. So it is frightening times for a lot of people. And what's really worrying is that things don't seem to be getting better. Jeremy Hunt has said that he's going to talk to banks, and banks are going to help lenders they're going to help people with mortgages on a case-by-case basis, help people out if they can't pay. But it's not so much a question of not being able to pay. There are a lot of people who will just about manage to pay, but they are not going to be able to save any money, spend any money. And as we know, interest rates are going up, and they're going up on mortgages, but we're not feeling them so much on our savings. So
please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the TAO Media family. Please like and share TAO Media. We love you all. Please support TAO Media Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.